to do this, and it looks really good. If I can get the body off, that is. Oh, come on! Come on! Never take off bodies on camera, because they never do what they're supposed to. Come on! Ah, nope. Ah, cut! Cars! Hi, and welcome to RCKicks. On today's show, we're returning to a project that's been on the back burner for about a month now, and that is the Sand Scorcher by Tamiya that Rebecca built on the show. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. There's a link up here. And yes, well, finally, I'm getting back into it. Rebecca didn't feel comfortable painting the body, so she left it to me. So I've been kind of waiting, and I had to go to the car shop to get the body colours for it, and we're going to go box art pretty much. And Knight Customs got in contact with me and said, hey, we saw the video, we make great little engines for those, would you like to have some? So I said, yeah, and between you and me, I was kind of looking at getting one anyway, because it's like Tamiya knew that someone was going to do that. They left enough space at the back here that you can actually fit quite a substantial looking engine in the back with lots of different exhaust types to make it add another layer of realism. And I've seen a lot of people have done it, and it does look really good. You don't have to modify the body or anything, there's just enough room for you. I was thinking about getting a metal rear housing for this, but I wanted to wait until I'd fitted the engine to make sure there was gonna be enough room and things like that. But I'm thinking I'll probably change this rear bar to metal. And I've seen some front metal bumpers as well. This car is going to get a little bit of driving, but it's not going to be driven on a daily basis. It's more of a shelf queen that can be driven. Also, I found a humpback mint condition 7.2 battery for it. So that's really cool. And it does hold a bit of charge as well. So that adds to a bit more of the sort of retro feel of the car. So what are we going to do today? Well, basically we're going to paint up the engine. Now that sounds like quite an easy task, but there's a lot of detail on this thing. So I think it's going to take me quite a while. You've got a distributor, the coil pack, you've got belts, you've got air intakes. And once you fit this to the car, it actually fits really well. And if you look, you've got this weird cutout section, it actually attaches to the back, and the metal section becomes part of the engine, so it works really well. So I'm pretty chuffed with it. Exhaust wise, I did mess around with it for a bit. This one I thought was going to be the favorite, but once you fit it in the car, this exhaust bend over bit kind of goes down inside, so you don't really see it. So this is the one that we're going to go with. Also, you've got the sort of side cannons, but I don't think they stand out quite as much as this one. Now I a little caveat here, I am not a professional painter. I'm actually going to paint these up with paintbrush, Tamiya paint. I'm not going to use an airbrush or anything like that. So don't expect miracles, okay? I'm just going to do it as best I can, and hopefully it will turn out okay. I don't have tons of amazing techniques. I'm kind of winging it. So stay to the end if you might end up seeing something that's a total disaster, or it might turn out okay. I have no idea. Right, let's crack on. all done. That's the engine finished. I did a few bits and pieces on top of that. I managed to find an old servo wire, so I took two of the wires, the yellow one, sorry, the orange one and the black one, and I actually attached it to the coil at the distributor and then round to the heads. So it adds another layer of detail to it. Obviously this is not going to get run very often, so it's not really a problem, but if you're going to run it more often, you'll probably end up just ripping these off. But it looks really nice. But once you put it all in and then you put the body on, you don't really see a great deal of it. It kind of sits underneath at the back, but it just adds another layer of detail. So I had lots of fun doing that. It was really nice. I must start playing with my airbrush. I actually have an airbrush and an airbrush compressor, but I need a spray booth, and obviously with winter it makes it really difficult to spray indoors. So what's next? Well, we'll go to the body. I'm going to do standard box art. That will be coming soon. Thanks very much. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye bye.